A few weeks ago, I posted a QQE and Connor's RSI strategy generated using StrategyQuant's genetic algorithm. This strategy goes long when the Connor's RSI is below 70 and the QQE fast line crosses over the slow line. The 10-year backtest from 2013 to 2022 shows consistency across both the 5-year in sample and 5-year out of sample portions. For a step-by-step guide on how I created this strategy, check out the link in the description. Bond1025 asked if I could run a walk-forward test on the strategy, and I thought, why not? I'll quickly run through the walk-forward optimization process. It involves running repeated cycles of in-sample parameter optimization followed by out-of-sample testing. For example, a strategy can be optimized from 2010 to 2012 and run out of sample in 2013. After repeating this cycle multiple times, you can combine the out-of-sample portions to create a long out-of-sample backtest. These repeated out-of-sample tests help you quantify your strategy's robustness, which is its insensitivity to the changing market conditions you will encounter in live trading. Two critical parameters when setting up your optimization are the number of optimization runs and the out-of-sample percentage. For starters, I will pick the middle ground and choose 20 runs with 20% out of sample. Let's proceed to set up the optimizer in StrategyQuant. I will use the exact method whereby backtests are run for every single parameter combination. In the simulated option, a genetic optimization is run once and the results for different parameter combinations are simulated. This is much faster but less accurate. I tested all three options for this particular strategy and the differences are minor, but your mileage may vary. Floating means the data segments will move forward in time as the optimization progresses. In theory, this should help the strategy adapt better to current market conditions. The number of runs and out-of-sample percentage are both set at 20. For the percent variation of parameters, I will set the upper and lower limits at ±30%. Robust strategies should continue to perform without drastic changes in parameter values. If a strategy's optimal parameters jumps drastically between optimization runs, its robustness should be suspect. With recommended parameters checked, only important parameters like look-back periods and exit parameters will be optimized. Heavily optimized strategies will collapse even with small changes in market conditions, so always tread lightly when optimizing. Passing criteria will be fairly standard. The key statistic is the net profit stability, better known as the walk-forward efficiency. With the bar set at 50%, this means the annualized returns of the out-of-sample portions must be at least half of those over the in-sample portions. The percentage of profitable runs and maximum profit per run help ensure minimum levels of consistency over the test. The robustness score measures the percentage of conditions to pass. Since I want all three, it's set to 100. Now for the results. Oh boy, the net profit stability is a measly 16%, and too few runs are profitable. The equity curve is depressing. The gray line, which is the original strategy without periodic reoptimizations, performed much better over the second half of the backtest. When a walk-forward optimization fails, these are the three common reasons. Let's examine them one by one. Perhaps the strategy is simply not robust enough. When the original strategy was generated, it used the first 5 years for in-sample optimizations. The default parameters for the Connor's RSI, entry price, and trade exit were derived by fitting the strategy to that data segment. Since the walk-forward optimization experiments with parameters within a ±30% range of those default values, it's logical to expect the first 5 years of the optimization to perform better, which is exactly what we have here. But the original backtest with default parameters shows the strategy performed similarly well over the out-of-sample portion, which casts some doubt on this explanation. An alternative explanation is that the strategy doesn't benefit from periodic reoptimizations. Some opponents of walk-forward optimization argue that reoptimizations are akin to chasing the market. By the time the optimal parameter set is applied, the market may have already shifted, and the new parameters are always one step behind. This is a complicated issue, and I don't know of any concrete method that determines whether a strategy should trade with either static or periodically reoptimized parameters. The last reason is that the walk-forward settings applied earlier simply do not suit the strategy. Fortunately, we can turn to StrategyQuant's walk-forward matrix for some answers. The matrix allows you to run multiple walk-forward optimizations, each with different settings. I will experiment with a range of optimization runs and out of sample percentages shown here. This will produce 20 different tests. There is an additional passing criteria, whereby there must be at least 7 cells and a 9-cell matrix that have a 100% robustness score. Robustness testing is all about finding consistency across strategy parameters and market conditions. For this strategy, matrix results are bad. Not a single one of the 20 cells passes all 3 conditions. The strategy has the best return over drawdown when 25 runs and 20% out of sample is used, but still slightly underperforms the unoptimized version. Since the matrix is bad across the board, it's more likely that the strategy is either not robust or trades better with static parameters. With these test results, I certainly wouldn't rush to trade the strategy. I'd run other robustness tests like multiple timeframe testing or use Monte Carlo simulations to randomize the price data. I'll link these guides at the end of the video. The vast majority of your strategies should and will fail robustness testing. Fortunately, since you can efficiently generate hundreds if not thousands of strategies, arriving at a final basket of 10 to 20 robust strategies is very much doable. Thanks for watching, and do subscribe if you want more honest trading content.